Hi everyone, I'm back again. So I have a little bit of a different video to do this time around. This isn't actually really anything to do with makeup. This is actually, I saw a video that one of the makeup artists that I follow on YouTube did, and she did hers a couple years ago, but I've only just recently subscribed to her, so I only just now saw it, but you know, it kind of inspired me to do this video. And in her video, she actually opened up about her struggle with anxiety and depression. And she also has a skin disorder, which, you know, for makeup artists is kind of a big deal. So she opened up and she talked about all of that stuff. And it kind of inspired me to do kind of my own thing. If you don't know me in my personal life, I do actually suffer from clinical depression, generalized anxiety disorder, and I have a mild form of PTSD. So, you know, that's a thing that I deal with every day. You know, this isn't, don't think that this is just me reaching out for pity and likes and stuff. I don't want pity. You know, this is something that I've dealt with literally all my life. As far back as I can remember, I've had anxiety issues. I had horrible separation anxiety when I was a kid. You know, when I first started school and everything, my parents would drop me off at school and I would spend the whole day wanting to go back home to my mom. And I actually, at one point in first grade, my first grade teacher was kind of an awful person. She never should have been allowed to be anywhere near children, first of all, because she was a cunt. Oh my God, she was awful. I could do a whole video about what an awful person she was, but I remember actually locking myself in the coat closet and refusing to come out until my mother came to pick me up from school because I had such horrible separation anxiety. And you know, as I got older, and I didn't even realize it until I was an adult, but you know, I dealt with a lot of stuff that my peers weren't necessarily going through. And I mean, I had a little bit of a different home life than my peers did. You know, my parents' relationship was always really rocky, and they actually ended up getting divorced when I was about 14, which, you know, it was so much better that way. But at the same time, you know, you kind of idolize your parents and their marriage and their relationship. So, you know, any of you who have gone through watching parents get divorced, you know, it's kind of tough because you kind of see that as the standard, and then all of a sudden they're not together anymore and you're like, why? And there's a lot of guilt that goes with it and everything. And you know, so I dealt with a lot of really rocky stuff in my childhood. I mean, my sister and I ran away from home a few times. We were actually both mentally and physically abused as children, which again, you know, we didn't even know until we were much older. You know, I've been through quite a bit. You know, we were poverty level. We had no money. It was a good week if Dad came home with enough money to get milk so we could have mac and cheese instead of ramen. You know, we were not very privileged. We, you know, we didn't have a lot. And, you know, a lot of that has kind of shaped a lot of who I've become. And, you know, because of a lot of those outside factors, as well as a couple of hereditary deep predispositions, I have actually developed a number of mental illnesses. And excuse me. You know, it's been something that I've dealt with for a very long time. And you know, being that I'm a girl, you know, I hit my teenage years, and you know, I hit puberty, and I became very emotional. And I've always been an emotionally driven person, but I mean, like, very emotional. Oh my God, I had so many emotions coursing through my body, and it was like I was on fire all the time. I was so overwhelmed with it. And you know, being that I'm a girl, a lot of people told me, it's okay, you're just going through puberty, you're gonna grow out of it. And you know, I kind of internalized that, but I was looking at my friends who are the same age as me, going through puberty just like me, and they didn't have the same issues that I was having. They didn't have a lot of, like, they didn't have the crazy emotional swings, and they didn't have these thoughts where they felt completely worthless. And, you know, I was looking at it and I was like, there's got to be something wrong with me. But so many people, adults, even adults that I trusted, not even just my parents, who I didn't have a good relationship with, aunts and uncles and friends of the family who I trusted completely. And, you know, these are people, some of them work in the medical field, you know, so I was like, they know what they're talking about. And they were telling me, it's okay, you know, it's just a phase, you're going to grow out of it. And I never did. When I was 15, I got into a relationship with a guy, and, you know, it was good for a while. You know, we were, you know, high school sweethearts or whatever. We dated for about a year and a half, and then we broke up, and I didn't know what to do with myself. The entire last year and a half of my life had been me dating him, and, you know, I didn't know how to redefine myself, and partially because of that, I went into this horrible downward spiral. This was also right after my parents got divorced. My dad had just gotten remarried. My mom was dealing with her own struggles with alcoholism and depression and a really rocky relationship with my now stepdad. You know, there was so much going on. And then my boyfriend, the one person that I thought was steady, broke up with me, and at the time, for no reason. You know, I didn't find out a reason for that until much later. But so it sent me into this horrible downward spiral. I cut myself. I shredded my arms up. I don't know if the video will even show it. There's not the top half of my hand, because that's cat scratches. I was playing with the cat, but all along the side of my left hand here, all down here. I don't know if the scars are really that visible, but all up my wrists, I have scars all down my thighs. I was cutting myself almost every day, because it was the only way that I could cope. It sounds super emo and cliche, but the pain let me know I was alive, because I felt completely dead inside. And, you know, I had insomnia. I felt completely worthless. I was crying at the drop of a hat. And, you know, none of my other peers were going through this. They would break up, they would be sad, but they would pick up and they would move on. They would deal with it. And for almost 2 years, I couldn't pick up and move on, and I didn't understand why. And, you know, that was when I really started to think, maybe there is something wrong with me. And, I started journaling a lot. I started, I buried myself in my artwork. I wrote a novel. It wasn't good. It was not good, but I did actually, I wrote a novel, to occupy my free time. I buried myself in studying music, because, you know, when I was a kid, that was what I wanted to be when I grew up. I wanted to be a singer. And, so, you know, I buried myself in my music and my artwork and anything to try and cope. And it helped a little, but not a lot. And, you know, I kind of had this, like, promise to myself. I, you know, because everybody had told me, you know, it's just a phase, you'll grow out of it. And I did a lot of research, and I found out that, you know, a lot of people, their brains are mature and balanced out by age 25. So I told myself that if I didn't level out by the time I was 25, I was going to do something about it. You know, I was going to get counseling or start medication or something. And I wrestled with this for at least 14 years, you know, unmedicated for a long time, when I probably should have been. But, you know, once I got with my now husband, you know, he kind of one, made me see what, like, a real good, stable relationship was supposed to be like, which, in my little world, was unfathomable. Real, functional relationships were the stuff of stories and movies, and they didn't actually exist in my life. And, you know, now it does. I mean, I've been with my husband for the last 7 years. We've been married for 3 of those 7 years. We have 2 children together, and, you know, I've gotten to a place where I'm happy now. He's helped me to rebuild my confidence, and, you know, he's supported me through a lot of stuff that a lot of other people wouldn't and haven't. So, you know, in that regard, I'm actually very lucky. But, you know, I've also, you know, I started to realize that, you know, there really is something, you know, there's something wrong inside my body. There's something that's not working. You know, I actually, you know, I didn't do anything about it for a long time because I didn't want to be a zombie and just be drugged up just to be quiet and be a part of society. I thought I was going to completely lose myself. You know, and I was just trying so hard to work through it. And then I had the kids and I developed a panic disorder along with my generalized anxiety. And, you know, I was having panic attacks left and right. I was going to the emergency room at least once a month. You know, it wasn't good. I couldn't live like that anymore. So I finally just said, fuck it. I'm going to do something about it. I can't do this to my kids. I'm not going to let my kids have the same childhood that I had. And so I sucked it up. I went to the doctor and I said, look, I know what the problem is. I'm mostly self-diagnosed, but I know exactly what the problem is. And I talked to my doctor and she said, yeah, you seem to know pretty much what's going on. And, you know, I finally decided I want to go the route of medication. You know, I don't feel comfortable really talking to people about my life. You know, this video is kind of a big deal. You know, I don't usually, talk to people about a lot of stuff because, you know, I don't want to feel like I'm a burden. And, I haven't really opened up about it until the last couple of years because, you know, I realized that I need to open up and people need to understand that this is why I am the way I am. But so I actually decided to get treatment for it, and I'm now on a maintenance medication. It's a very low dose. I don't take anything, like super fancy for it. I take the lowest dose of Lexapro, and all it does is it staves off the panic attacks so that I can, kind of work through my anxiety on my own. And it gives me just that little extra push with my depression so that I can at least get out of bed and I can, you know, mentally deal with it. What the medication does is my body doesn't produce enough serotonin, and the serotonin that it does produce, it doesn't know how to reabsorb. So what the medication does is it helps my body to actually produce the neurotoxins that I need, and then, or I'm sorry, it's not neurotoxins. It's, I can't remember the word. The word is gone. But it's not neurotoxins. That's the wrong word. That's poison. That'll kill you. But it helps my body release the chemicals that I need to function on a quote unquote normal level. I know I've said it, I said this all throughout the video so far, but, you know, there's nothing actually wrong with me. I have a chemical imbalance. I'm not broken. I'm not like not normal per se. Society has this huge stigma around mental illnesses, and they have certain standards that you have to meet to be considered normal, and I don't fit those. You know, I process information so differently because of my anxiety. You know, every little thing, just making these videos is a huge deal for me because 3 years ago, I would have never thought that I would have the confidence to put myself out there where the entire world can see me and could make negative comments about me, about my looks, about my skills as a makeup artist, about anything. And 3 years ago, I wouldn't have been able to do it. I would not have made it past the initial anxiety attack. You know, and I've gotten to a place now where I'm confident enough that I can do this sort of thing and I can pursue this that I love, this makeup endeavor, and, you know, doing the makeup tutorials, which people have been asking me to do for years because they've always thought that my makeup was so great. And, you know, I'm finally at a place where I can do that. And it's this amazing feeling for me. For the first time in my life, I am 27 years old, okay? In case you don't know that, I'm 27 years old right now. And for the first time in my life, I can honestly say I'm happy with my life. You know, and not just because I have, you know, my husband and my kids. You know, they're amazing and they do make me happy, but they're not the only things that make me happy. I make me happy now. I'm doing things with my life that I'm actually proud of. You know, I have this newfound sense of self-worth that I haven't had for my entire life. And, you know, I guess I wanna use that and put it to good use, because, you know, depression and anxiety and mental illnesses affect millions of people every year. You know, new people are getting diagnosed with it every single year. And there's all these added stressors with, like, the political climate right now. There's, you know, the whole financial climate right now. You know, people my age, they're not doing things that the generations before us did because, you know, they can't afford it. And it's, you know, it's causing people to develop these mental illnesses. And, you know, I guess I want people to know that they're not alone and there is light at the end of the tunnel. You know, you're gonna come out of that darkness and you're gonna be okay. You know, for a long time, I thought there was no light at the end of the tunnel. I hit rock bottom. I was self-harming. I was suicidal. A lot of people don't know this, but I actually had planned my own death. And, you know, I had it all figured out. I knew I couldn't go on anymore. And, you know, I couldn't deal with everything going on. And I legitimately planned and almost attempted suicide. I chickened out at the last minute, and I'm so glad that I did, because, you know, 17-year-old me didn't know that there was so much more. And now, 10 years later, I have everything that I dreamed about. I have, you know, a family. I have a husband who loves me and treats me with respect. And, you know, he puts up with my crazy, and, you know, he just kind of rolls with the punches, so to speak. There's not actual punches. Let me just throw that out there. I'm not quite that crazy, but, you know, he has helped me a lot, and I couldn't ask for anything better. So, you know, now that I've hit the upswing in this, I guess I just want to let people know that, you know, it is going to be okay, and that, you know, there is light at the end of the tunnel. And honestly, I'm always here. You know, you can go on my Facebook page and you can send me a message if you need someone to listen. You can, you know, you can talk to me. I have an email address that is public knowledge, and you're more than welcome to email me if you just need someone to open up to, if you don't feel safe talking to people in your life and you think some random person on the internet would be better just to get it off your chest. I am here for you, okay? All of whatever you tell me will remain between us, okay? And I'm not saying this like, oh, tell me all your problems. It's only if you want to, but I want to put that offer out there because I had people who did that for me, and they have actually now become lifelong friends. And, you know, that helped me a lot. So if that's something that you think you need, if you need some random person to talk to, I'm here. I've been through a lot, and, you know, maybe I can't give you insight on your life. Maybe I can't give you advice, but I can be the person that you, you know, unload the burden on. You know, I'm more than willing to be that person. So, you know, and if that's not something that, you know, you feel comfortable with, then, you know, there's other options as well. You could definitely look into counseling. There are, you know, there's plenty of online, you know, like message boards and everything where you can talk to other people that, you know, have dealt with these issues, and it's free. Or you can, if you're able to, you can see an actual counselor and get diagnosed. You can talk to your primary care physician if you have one, and, you know, discuss options there. You can do any number of things. And, I highly encourage seeking out some form of treatment, even if that's not medication, even if it's counseling or just writing or drawing or, you know, finding healthy coping mechanisms. Please, if you are able to do any of that, do it, okay? And if you're not, just know that there are people out there who suffer the same things. You're not alone, okay? And if you're not able to find treatment, you can make it through, all right? I made it through for 14 years without, you know, I made it through without anything. I had no medication. I had no healthy coping mechanisms. I had almost no support network, you know, except for a few people. And I still made it out okay. So there is hope for you. I feel like I'm kind of rambling, but I really want to get that point across, because that's, you know, that for me is a big deal. There is hope. So thank you guys for watching this. I know it's not really makeup related, and I know it's not, you know, something that people normally see or talk about, but I wholeheartedly believe in, you know, being honest with people. And, you know, for me, opening up about my mental illnesses and the things that I've gone through in my life has really helped me. It's helped me to understand myself better, and it's helped me to, you know, really recognize that, you know, treatment isn't a bad thing. You know, I'm not weak because I suffer from this. I'm not broken. I am a whole person who is worth something, even though I have, you know, a couple of extra things to deal with. You know, I've got baggage, and I have, you know, I've dealt with a lot of stuff in my life, but it's made me who I am, and I honestly think it's made me stronger. And, you know, now that I've gotten to a place where I'm confident, and, you know, for the first time in my life, I can look in the mirror even without makeup on, and I can feel beautiful. I can feel loved by myself. I can look at myself and I can be proud of who I am as a person, as a mother, as a wife. You know, I can be proud of everything that I have accomplished thus far. And that is a huge deal for me. So I guess I kind of want to pay it forward, you know, and just know that, you know, I may not know you personally. I may not know exactly what you're going through, but I am proud of you. Okay. I am. You are surviving every single day. That is your goal, is to just survive to the next day. Okay. And you're doing that. If you do nothing else that day, if you just lay in bed and feel miserable, you survive. Okay. And boom, that's a checklist. That is boom, check mark. You made your goal for the day. You survived. Okay? That's all I want you to do right now, is survive. And I am here for you, and I love you. And I am so proud of you for surviving. Okay? Just know that. All right? So thank you guys so much for watching. I know this was kind of like a little personal, and maybe you're learning things that, you know, maybe you don't want to know about me, but, you know, I feel comfortable talking about it at this point in my life, so I feel like I should, and I feel like I should tell my story. If you want to know more, feel free to email me, or, you know, message me on Facebook, or you can even leave a comment on the video. I don't care. I am very open about the things that I've gone through, so If you do have questions, feel free to ask them, and I am more than willing to answer them. So thank you guys so much for continuing to support me. It really does mean a lot because, like I've said in other videos, this is what I want to do with my life. So this means a lot to me, and the fact that I have new subscribers all the time and people are supporting me in this endeavor is huge for me. So thank you so much for all of that. I will see you guys all next time for another video, and I love you all. Mwah! Bye-bye.